Hello everyone, welcome to the session of class 9 mathematics, and I'm your Anu again from maxpool.com. Last class we saw all about angle side angle criterion, isn't it? We have just completed two criterions of congruency, and this is the third one which states that it is angle side congruency criterion, right? So we have totally five congruency criterion, and out of which we have seen just two, and this is angle side congruency criterion. That is, the previous ones were two angles and side, and between two sides and angle enclosed between, isn't it? So this what means is two angles and one side, those two angles and the side, that is two angles can be equal and one side which is not enclosed within it. Okay, do you understand? So any two angles and any one side, so that will be easy for you than the previous ones, because we need not look for a pattern. We can just see for two angles and one side separately, and that's it. Okay, so just remember to spot two triangles during any time of congruency sums, and when you spot the triangles, do keep in mind that you need to name the triangles properly in order, so the rest will fall in place automatically, and you will find it very easier to prove the rest of the conditions. Okay, so now let's move on to angle side congruency criterion. So what does it mean? Actually, if you are given two triangles, see, one is ABC, another one is DEF, we say that if one angle, see, B, if B is equal to E and A is equal to D, and one of the sides BC is equal to EF, we need to prove both the triangles to be congruent. Now how do we do that? So to understand the criterion, that is, if any two angles, if any one side is given, then given and the corresponding angles and sides of one triangle are equal to the other correspondingly, then we can say that the triangles are congruent. Now how do we prove this? Now let us take A equal to D. What is given? Angle A is equal to angle D, right? Angle A is equal to angle D. Now angle B is equal to angle E. Okay, now the side BC is equal to EF, right? So these are the conditions which you are given with. Now from A, D, B, A is equal to D and B is equal to E, we can write, see, A plus B, okay, A, angle A plus angle B, I added these two, so that has to be equal to angle B plus E, isn't it? Because angle A is equal to angle B, D and angle B is equal to angle E. So A plus B is equal to angle E. D plus angle E, right? Okay, so angle B, this is A plus B and D plus E. So why I have added these two to get the angle C, right? Because so my aim is to prove that if we have two angles and side somewhere else, which is not enclosed within these two angles, side somewhere else, then two, we have the two triangles to be congruent. So that I need to prove with the help of previously proved congruency criteria. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is, I have A here, B here, and a side is there. So according to our previous criterion, we know two angles and side enclosed within it, if they are equal, then we can say that the triangles are congruent, right? So that is what we are trying to do. I have to find this angle, and I need to show that it is equal to angle F also, right? So that is what we are trying to do. A plus B, what is it? It is equal to, so according to angle sum property in a triangle, all the angles should sum up to 180 degrees, isn't it? So A plus B is equal to 180 minus angle C. Is it right? Yes. Now this is equal to, so D plus E, I have added D plus E, and that should be equal to 180 degree minus angle F. Right? Is it okay? Now 180 gets cancelled, both sides, so C will be equal to F. Now we have found that angle C is also equal to angle F. Now if you observe, see, we have B to E equal, C and F equal, and the side enclosed within is equal, right? So now according to According to ASA criterion, we have angle B is equal to angle E, angle C is equal to angle F, and the BC side is equal to EF. Therefore, we say according to ASA criterion, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. So don't forget to name the triangles in order. I've said you. See, ABC is congruent to DEF. So from the naming itself, we'll be able to take out the CPCT part. See, AB is equal to DE now. AB is equal to DE. BC is equal to EF automatically comes. Then AC is equal to DF. AC is equal to DF. See, it is almost right. Then B is equal to E. C is equal to F. A is equal to D. So that's how we prove the two triangles are congruent according to ASA criterion. Now from this, what we conclude? We conclude that even when two angles and the side not associated with it, that is the side which is not enclosed, some other side they have given that to be equal, then also I can say that the triangles are congruent. So this is according to angle side criterion. Angle means two angle and one side somewhere else, not enclosed within those two angles or any other side to be equal. So that is what angle side congruency criterion means. Okay, so now this is the first theorem in angle side congruence criteria. That is, if two angles and a side are equal to the corresponding angles and side of another triangle, if one triangle is equal to another triangle, then we say that those two triangles are congruent. So this is your first theorem. So we'll see the next one. Hope you understood this. We have proved AS criterion with the help of angle side angle criterion. So after understanding all the criteria, after coming to know all the congruence criteria, we will be able to solve the congruency in triangles very easily because we have five criteria. Okay, so then that will be easy to analyze the triangle. So either you can say it by ASA or AAS. So anything will be possible when you spot just two triangles in the diagram. Okay, so now we'll move on to the next problem. So the next problem, what does it say? See, I've just drawn the diagram. I'll explain you what it is. See, in this diagram, we have a triangle. So I'll just name it as, I'll just name it as ABC, triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, if you're given with two angles to be equal, so you are given B is equal to C, right? So when two angles are equal in a triangle, then what can we say is the sides opposite to those equal angles are also equal. That is the side AB, which is equal, which is opposite to C, and the side AC, which is opposite to angle B, will also be equal. Okay, so that we need to prove. So how do we go about that? So we have angles B is equal to C. Okay, now what do we do? We have just only one triangle. So to make it as two triangles, what do we do is we draw a bisector, angle bisector from A. Okay, from the vertex A, we are drawing a bisector. So let it meet at B. So what it is? AD is an angle bisector which meets BC at D. Okay, now we have got two separate triangles. Okay, so these are two separate angles, and what do I need to prove? I need to prove AB is equal to AC. So I have to prove AB is equal to AC given B is equal to C. B is equal to C, I need to prove these two sides are equal. So how do we do that? If at all we need to prove some two sides to be equal or two angles to be equal, then what do we how do we approach? we just take the congruency criterion by any one of the congruency criterion. If we prove that the two triangles are congruent, then according to CPCT, that is corresponding parts of the corresponding triangles are equal. We know that, isn't it? So all the three angles and all the three sides will be equal when triangles are congruent. That you should keep in mind. So that is what we are going to try to do. Now, these two triangles, take these two triangles now. See, first triangle is triangle ABD and the next one is triangle ACD. Name it properly, I said ABD and ACD. So we have drawn two triangles. Now in these two triangles, what do we have? We have angle B is equal to angle C, that is given. Okay, so that is given, two angles are equal. Now this is the angle bisector. We have angle bisector here. So these two angles have to be equal, right? So the angle, what is this angle? Angle BAD is equal to angle CAD. CAD, BAD is equal to CAD because since this is the angle bisector, so it divides the angle into two equal halves. So these two angles are equal, right? Now next is the line AD. See the line AD. AD is equal to AD because for both the triangles, because it is the common side for both the triangles, right? So for these two triangles, AD is common. Now what do we have? We have two angles here to be equal, this angle and this angle for this triangle, this angle and this angle for this triangle, and the common side to be equal. So according to what it is? According to AAS criterion. So we have the angle-angle side criterion here. Two angles and some other side. Angle-angle side criterion. We have these two triangles to be congruent. So triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. So that's it. So we have proved two triangles to be congruent. So if two triangles are congruent, then what do we conclude? According to CPCT. So according to CPCT, what do we have? We have all the angles and sides to be equal, right? So from that we prove that AB is equal to AC. So according to CPCT, we have AB is equal to AC because AB is side of this triangle and AC this side of triangle, corresponding side of this triangle. So AB of ABD is equal to AC of ACD. So that is how we prove, by using angle-angle side criterion, that is when two angles in a triangle are equal, the sides opposite to them are also equal. So that is proved according to AAS criteria. Do you understand? So I hope you understood this. Let us move on to the next one. Now what do we understand by the sum we have just now proved? So you can also name that, isn't it? So when two sides are equal, that is called an isosceles triangle, right? So in an isosceles triangle, that is when two sides of a triangle are equal, then the angles opposite to those two equal sides will also be equal, right? Isn't it? So just keep it in mind, when you have two equal angles, the opposite sides to them are also equal. Now the next one, the third one is, what we have? We have a triangle right here. Okay, in the triangle ABC. So in the triangle ABC, what do we do is, we drop an altitude from the vertex A. So what do you mean by altitude? I redraw it here. We have a triangle like this. I drop an altitude. Altitude of the triangle is always perpendicular to the base. Keep that in mind. It is always perpendicular to the base. So 90 degree both sides because it's perpendicular to the base. And the other thing is, they have given that it bisects the base also. So if it does like that, because usually all the altitudes, all the triangles will not have the altitude bisecting their base. Okay, so it has a condition. So what do we say is, the altitude drop from the vertex perpendicular, because altitude means it is perpendicular, to drop to the base of a triangle, and if it bisects the base, what do you mean by bisecting? Dividing it into two equal halves, isn't it? So if it bisects the base, then we understand that the triangle is isosceles. Do you understand? What do I say? The triangle is, then the triangle is isosceles. What do you mean by isosceles? We have two sides to be equal. See, we have two sides to be equal. Okay. So, these two sides are equal. That we need to prove. Okay. So, it is not given here. Actually, the theorem is, when the altitude dropped from a vertex to the base, and if the altitude bisects the base, then the given triangle is an isosceles. So that we need to prove. The isosceles part we need to prove by one of the criteria. Okay. So how do we prove that? Again, so this is just the kind of the problem we just now saw. It is a reverse problem. And see, it, this is a triangle. Let us take this point as D. Okay. So from triangle ABD and triangle ACD, we have two triangles here. We have spotted two triangles. Now, what do we do? What do we have? See, we have BD is equal to CD, right? BD is equal to CD because the altitude bisects the base is given. So BD is equal to CD. And what about AD? AD is equal to AD because it is a common side. So these two, this is common side, we know, and this is given, right? Now, what about the angle between these two sides? See, this is also 90, this is also 90, because I said altitude is always perpendicular to the base. So, angle ADB is equal to angle ADC is equal to 90 degrees. So, according to what can be said about this? So according to SAS criterion, isn't it? So according to SAS criterion, because this is one side, this is one side, and this is the angle here. Okay. So according to SAS criterion, we have triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. So that's it. Upon proving the congruency, by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles, we have AB is equal to AC. So if AB is equal to AC, what can be said about the triangle? So when two sides are equal, then we can name the triangle as an isosceles triangle. So here, of course, we have not used the angle-angle side criterion, but just for our understanding, we have taken SAS criterion here, and there is a theorem behind it. That is, when an altitude is dropped from one of the vertex and which bisects the base, then the triangle has to be isosceles. Okay. So up to this, keep a note and check the sums we have tried here. We'll continue in the next class. Until then, it's bye from Anu for AAS Congress criterion. Thank you.